This American guy in the Baguio province is living off 350 buckaroos a month, including immigration. Is it possible? Is this possible? Let's talk about this. So a few weeks ago, I made a vid on how I lived on $600 a month. So that subscriber of mine, he commented on that vid and told me about how he was living off $300 a month. Here is the comment.
So I just want to read this to you. I won't read the whole thing, just a bit. So he's been living in the Philippines for 5 months. So his average budget over the past 3 months since moving in with the GF has been $300 a month. Now, later on, I realized this $300 was excluding immigration because he plans on marrying his girlfriend. So he won't have immigration fees after that, apparently. So I live in a rural area in the mountains where I don't need aircon. So he's in the Baguio area because it stays relatively cool all the time. That's very true. And the cost of living and the house I rent is extremely low. Okay, so he has low rent. Also, my girlfriend does most of the shopping to get local prices, big plus. So as you can see here, this is the specific budget we got here. So the Baguio guy, he lives on $350. I, on a budget as a traveler, was spending $600. So this guy here, the Baguio guy, he's not a traveler. He has settled into a home with a girlfriend in the province. And so let's see how he's living much cheaper than I am. So in my vid, I was spending $10,000 on rent. So he's spending $8,000. And these, both of these numbers include everything. Utilities, internet, everything, the accommodation-wise. Is this expense here. So he's saving only about $20 here. And so with breakfast, it's about what I was eating. Three eggs, rice. I wasn't eating fruit, but I was going out to a Carinderia. So the Carinderia, they've got to make a profit. So I was spending $1,500. He's spending just $1,000. So again, he's saving a bit of money there. Then we get into lunch here. I was eating at SM Mall every day. So I was spending quite a bit more than him, 5,000 pesos compared to 1,500. And you can see what he was eating. He was eating Filipino food, quite good. And then we got into dinner. He's beating me by, or I beat him actually by a bit here. So, but the difference is I was eating crap Carinderia food. And he had some very nice meat and he had a nice dinner going on here. So that's his monthly budget for dinner. Then we got the miscellaneous. I was spending more on beer. I don't know his miscellaneous stuff. I think that goes to luxuries. He buys nice cooking oil. And so that's the miscellaneous category. He beats me there. Starbucks. He didn't have a Starbucks where he is. So he beats me there. He saves an extra $70. I guess if I were in the province, I'd be happy just having coffee on my patio. But since I was in an Airbnb with no patio, I had to go to a coffee shop. So here we have immigration. It's $2,600 a month. Can someone in the comment section confirm, is this what you're spending a month? Because that's more than what I was spending. When I did my budget, it was exactly 30,000 or under, but I wasn't spending this much on immigration. I was spending under 2,000, as I remember. And so I upped my budget here. Originally, it was 30,000. I put it to 30,006 because I was already over with my budget. But if I did it exactly with the new immigration, I'd be spending 30,600. And so you can see he's beating me by quite a bit, 12,000. He's beating me by about 150 buckaroos. So let's talk a little more.
Okay, so Baguio guy has four tipperoos and we're gonna go through these four tips, okay? One by one, let's go. So I consider this Baguio guy sort of the expert on living cheap because this guy taught me. He sort of organized the living cheap thing. So we're gonna just dissect this a bit. So tip number one is live in the province. So the Baguio guy, he settled in Baguio because he met a girl who is from Baguio. Baguio is her hometown. And that's his tip, is to meet a province girl and to settle down in her hometown. Now, a lot of people think, well, that's a recipe for disaster. The fam is right there. They're gonna be asking for money all the time. Well, hey, the reality is it depends on the chick, man. If you get a crap chick, okay, like I got in Bohol, she's gonna rinse you, milk you for money. But there are good girls out there who respect you. They respect you. They respect that you're living on a budget. Anyway, once you've found your specific place, area, barangay that you wanna live, you're gonna make savings just based on connections, just based on learning. As time goes on, you're gonna learn where to go. Where to go to get cheap this, where to go to get the best that, where to go to get free mangoes and free coconuts. And so that is tip number one. Let's get into tip number two. Tip number two is living in the mountains. Living in the mountains means you don't need aircon. I mean, Baguio guy, he wears pants, he wears long sleeves, he wears a jacket. I mean, compare this to like living in Dumaguete where you're sweltering all the time, especially in the afternoon. And so anyway, he says that he likes living in the mountains because it's just more pleasant. You can spend the entire day outside. And as someone who's been to Baguio, I can vouch for that. It is cool in the afternoon. You don't get that sweltering heat that you get on the mainland. So the two main mountain areas in Philippines are, number one, the most famous is Baguio. And number two, the not so famous is the Bukidnon region in Mindanao. Now, what few people understand about Baguio is that Baguio is the known city in the mountain, but Baguio is just a small part of a huge mountainous area.
Here is Baguio. Okay, so look at Baguio is a mountainous area, but you can see, although Baguio has the name of mountainous area, you can see the mountains extend all the way up here. It's just that these cities here, around here, they are not so well known, but you know, where the red pin is here, this is the highest area. So this is much higher than Baguio itself, right? But you got villages and you got cities up here, but you got villages all around and they're all mountainous. They're all cool weather.
And in the mountainous area, there are plenty of smaller cities, smaller villages, and great places to live. Comment down below if you live in one, if you live in the vast Baguio area, and comment, like, how do you like living there? The second place, Bukidnon, is lesser known, but anyone who's been there, you talk to anyone who's been to Bukidnon, they will tell you it is a magnificently beautiful part of Mindanao. You've probably heard of Tagaytay in the Cavite region, just southwest of Manila. So Tagaytay is a cooler area, but the problem with Tagaytay is it's not very vast. It's just not very big. You know, the biggest mountainous area is the Baguio area in Luzon. The second biggest mountainous area is Bukidnon in Mindanao. And Tagaytay, in comparison, is teeny tiny.
See here, Baguio is quite vast. It's all of this area. Now let's compare this to Tagaytay, okay? Tagaytay is right here. This is Tagaytay. You can see the difference. It's not very vast. And let's compare that to Bukidnon. Bukidnon is down here. Bukidnon's right here, okay? So Bukidnon's much bigger than Tagaytay, not as big as Baguio.
Tip number three for living on a budget, because a lot of people, they just don't have the option. They just don't have a lot of money. So this vid is for you guys and me included. I don't have a monthly income coming in, so I gotta live cheap because I'm not gonna make much online. I'm not a software developer. I just don't have a skill that's gonna make a bunch of money. Anyway, tip number three is is to have free hobbies, okay?
Boring.
A lot of guys, like if you see the info channel, he says he can't live cheap. He's got to go to the nice restaurant. He's got to go to resorts, stay at resorts. Well, I don't know. Look, I've been traveling my whole life. I don't need to do this stuff. I just like living a simple life. I am ready to settle down. Anyway, what are free hobbies? I'll tell you what the Baguio guy is doing, okay? He is a runner, so he likes running. He plays the guitar, which I don't. I'm not a music guy. He learns basic carpentry skills, which is cool because you know what, man? When I was at home in Vancouver, I needed to install a new sink. I installed it myself and I just learned everything on YouTube. So if I was going to learn carpentry, I would just do the same thing. I would turn on YouTube and how to build something in carpentry and just learn from there. He is also building with bamboo, which I think is a different kind of carpentry. And he spends time with his girlfriend in the house. I think that's pretty cool. You know, watch movies and, you know, just hang out together. And sometimes he will occasionally drink with the uncle and the neighbor. And that's pretty cool. I mean, when I was in Bohol, I drank with the papa, the grandpa, and the grandpa's friend. And, you know, we spoke English. We were drinking beer. And we just had a good time. We talked about life. You know, I was asking him the questions about, you know, how it was there when they were young. And we had a pleasant conversation. And that's what he recommended, the Baguio guy. I would also throw in board games. Board games are pretty cool. It's not a habit of mine, but when I do play board games, it is pretty fun. And I would throw in hiking because I love hiking. And if you're in the mountainous area, you got hiking all around you. And tip number four is to eat at home. Now, the good thing about Filipinas is that they love to cook. Also, if you got a nice Filipina who's cooking you some good food at home, you'll feel less of a desire to actually go out and go to restaurants. And if you actually do settle down in one spot, an idea is to grow your own food, which is what Baguio guy plans to do. And the Baguio guy, he threw in that it is a good idea to actually, if you're going to start a garden, to actually enjoy gardening, because the food there is, I mean, the local food is just so cheap that you don't actually save a lot of money by actually doing your own farming. It's more of something you can do to enjoy. It's something you can learn. And it, at the same time, it will save you a bit of dough. And the Baguio guy, he threw in that he does get the vast majority of his food at the local market, which there is plentiful food. You know, they talk about food shortages these days. Just go to a Filipino market. They got stacked up to yin yang with everything. And, you know, I can't see that ending in the Philippines because, I mean, look, the people have to make a living and they have to sell the food at a cost that the local people can buy it. Okay, I just want to throw in some other info. The reality is that the Baguio guy in his house, he does not have any hot water. But I just want to throw in my own two cents there. When I was in Manila at my very first girlfriend's house, we did not have any hot water. We would fill up some big, what you'd call like a big Western garbage can, and like one of those hard plastic garbage cans. We'd fill that up with water in the nighttime, and we had like a long rod, and the purpose of the rod was to heat water. We'd stick this in the water, and in 20 minutes, the entire bucket of water would be warm. So that's one tip on how to actually get warm water if you don't actually have warm water in the faucet. Myself, personally, I don't mind that Taobao thing. I mean, it's pretty cool, actually. And in the extra info category, I just want to throw in that one of the luxuries that he has is he likes to get high-quality cooking oil. So he'll go into the city. He'll venture into the city. He'll get high-quality cooking oil and bring that back home. Because the option is they have very low-quality cooking oil there. And if you're into health, if you are interested in health, you don't want to use that low quality cooking oil. So that is a priority for him. It's not a priority for everybody. So I asked him a couple questions. I said, how did you find your house? So he said, step one is knowing exactly the barangay where you want to live. Right? And that's true. That goes for anywhere in the whole world. You have to know exactly where you want to live before you start looking for a house. Now, if you're in the province, especially the far out province, you're probably not going to be living on your own. You're probably there with your girlfriend. I mean, especially if you've never been to that area. I mean, you know, we just don't do that. So you're probably in reality going to live somewhere that is comfortable to your girlfriend. So the two of you will walk around and ask around. You'll look for signs and eventually you'll find a place to rent. The Baguio guy, for example, they are renting a house from a family friend of the GF. And as you know, I mean, Filipinos are the world's best networkers. So if that's your goal, if your goal is to rent a place in the province, network and just ask people, where is a rental? I mean, someone will know. So I was kind of curious the condition of the house. So I'll tell you what he said. So he said it's a hollow block house. It's painted yellow. It's got a metal roof. And it's got red tile flooring. So it's got a bright interior, it's got a high ceiling, and it's got plenty of natural sunlight coming in from the windows. So his rent is about 3,500 pesos. So the video I'm about to play right now, it's about 40 seconds of footage. They're renting for 2,000 pesos. So the Baguio guy is probably living a slightly higher standard of housing than the guys in this video.
So this is another option. This place here, the video link for this one is down below, but this is only 2,000 pesos. And so they seem like they're happy here. It's 2,000 pesos a month for this place. It is in Zigihor Island, which is nearby Dumaguete, Bohol, in that area. It's just a small separate island. It's popular with tourists, but I don't think they have aircon. But I mean, if you are on a low budget, this place is 2,000 pesos or freaking 40 bucks. It's less than 40 bucks to rent this place for a month. And as you can see, what they're talking about in the vid is sort of modifications that he's made to this house. So for example, if it's you could just sign a long-term rental agreement with the person, maybe 3 years or longer. And therefore, anything that you are going to put into the house, you're going to get back. Because look, he hasn't made a lot of modifications. You can see that, you know, you put the furniture in there, you decorate it a bit, and, you know, you make it your home. And, you know, like personally, me, I've been traveling my whole life. And I'll tell you one thing for sure, no matter where you live, after a week, after 1 week, it wherever you live, it feels like home.
So after the Baguio guy gets married, he'll be living off 300 buckaroos a month, and that is how you live cheap in the Philippines. Please hit the like button, guys. Please hit the like button. I'll see you on the next vid. I think on the next vid, I'm gonna talk about Cebu. I spent a month in Cebu, and I'm gonna tell you what I did every day in Cebu. Okay, guys, so please sub.